His Excellency Peter Thompson, the President General of the United Nations General Assembly, the delegates from several parts of the world gathered here at the United Nations headquarters in New York, United States of America, for the United Nations General Assembly 28th June on high level event on education. My name is Chivumbi Ernest Benjamin, the President General of Heal the Planet Global Organization, Nama Swahil Entebbe Highway, Kampala, Uganda, East Africa. We've not had an opportunity to appear in person for this high level event here at the United Nations headquarters, but we would wish to contribute on the agenda. The reason why you are convening here today, 28th June 2017, is in respect of goal number 4 of the SDG, which you clearly state that despite the progress, the world has failed to meet the Millennium Development Goal of achieving universal primary education by 2015. In 2013, the latest year of which data are available, 59 million children of primary school age were out of school. Estimates show that among those 59 million children, 1 in 5 of those children had dropped out, and recent trends suggest that 2 in 5 out of these school children will never set foot in a classroom. The Sustainable Development Goal further states and clearly recognizes this gap, which must be closed, even as the international community more explicitly addresses the challenges of the equality and equity. Measuring and learning the achievement, starting in the early grades, will help to identify where schools are failing to meet their commitments to children, to formulate appropriate remedy action. For example, data of 2013 from 15 Latin American countries that show that in 6 countries, fewer than 50% of the third graders had a minimum level of proficiency in mathematics. In 3 countries, fewer than half were proficient in reading. At the end of the primary school, children should be able to read and write and to understand and use basic concepts in mathematics. However, in 2014, between 40% and 90% of children failed to achieve even minimum levels of proficiency in reading. In 10 African countries where I come from, and in 9 of these failed to achieve, in these countries, between 40% and 90% of these children failed to achieve minimum levels of proficiency in mathematics. The end of the lower secondary education often coincides with the end of compulsory education. By this stage, young people should be able to master subjects related to knowledge and skills and possess personal and social skills. Data from 38 countries in developed regions show that in the majority of those countries, at least 75% of young people achieved at least a minimum of proficiency in reading and other mathematics. Likely, finally, on that matter, because the nations are aware of this SDG number 4, but on that note, official development assistance for education scholarships amounted to 1.1 billion US dollars annually from 2001 to 2011, from 2011 to 2013. which totaled to $1.2 billion in 2014, with Australia, France, and Japan being the biggest, being the largest contributors, as the source applies. The United Nations General Assembly gathered here again at UN headquarters in New York. Just like you state that the Sustainable Development Goal 4, which I've just partially elucidated, the goal number 4 on education is at the heart of the United Nations Agenda 2013. The agenda and essential for the success of all the Sustainable Development Goals. National governments and international community need to ensure quality education for all and smart, innovative measures to reach young learners and education and training which are more relevant in addressing the social, environmental and economic challenges that face the world. Education on the basis of equality for girls and boys, women and men across the universe, and in respect of education systems, initiatives is also critical in achieving gender equality, reducing child mortality, delaying marriage, and generating female leaders amongst other factors that contribute to the societal progress. You further state that raising awareness of the new development agenda, fostering better understanding about the SDGs, their interconnectedness, and promoting global citizenship all play an instrumental role in making progress not only towards SDG 4, but also towards the entire Agenda 2013. This is what Heal the Planet Global Organization can state on the subject, that education with all its stated intents cannot be achieved unless the developing parts of the world can be able to work with the governments through the Ministry of Education in these respective countries in a well-defined manner, would be in position to have an integrated curriculum which promotes a green education, which promotes gender equality and respect, amongst other important issues. We therefore suggest that if we are to achieve such an important element as SDG number 4, that United Nations must work with governments, individuals, organizations and companies to look at children who are studying. Because research shows it very clear that once an upcoming child is inculcated any value, such will never be forgotten. Heal the Planet Global Organization is appealing to the stakeholders, to this General Assembly seated here in New York, to think more of increasing funding, to think more of engaging with schools, to think more of raising potential ambassadors, audience who are going to spread this message across schools all over the world. Because education is not just for the sake of education, it is for the sake of imparting these values that we need, upon which the youngsters will be able to use to spearhead campaigns and advocate for what is more relevant. Different countries, especially in Uganda where I come from, students are tackling issues that do not concern them and at any one simple time will ever be relevant to them. They are undertaking subjects that are not relevant at all. So engulfing the SDGs into the curriculum of countries is very, very much vital. So this is what we think can be our submission. His Excellency, Mr. President, the General, the President General of United Nations, that we can make. And we hope that the delegates who are gathered here in New York will be able to break down and have realistic solutions to the challenges that are facing this sector. Thank you so much, Chivumbi Ernest Benjamin, President General, Heal the Planet Global Organization.